Welcome to the video discussion on communication campaigns. Today's discussion is about planning a communication campaign. And we have a very eminent person with us today to discuss about communication campaigns. And he is none other than Mr. M.J.R. David. A very warm welcome to you, Mr. M.J.R. David. Let me start the discussion by asking, we have lots of communication programs, but we tend to focus more on communication campaigns. Why is that?
Yeah, now communication programs is the wide application of communication.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for instance, if there's an organization, if there's a country, if there is an institution, we could look at a communication program, which is the broad application.
Mm-hmm.
Here, what we try to do is see how you could apply communication. But now, when you come to communication campaigns,
mm-hmm.
it's more strategic.
Mm-hmm.
Within a certain planned time, we try to attain strategic objectives
mm-hmm.
With given resources.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, we plan within X number of months, we are going to create awareness among X number of people
mm-hmm.
and have certain action outputs.
Okay.
Now, this is a communication campaign.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think communication programs is the broader application and communication campaigns is the more focused application.
Okay. Let me ask you, what is a campaign? What is a communication campaign?
Right. Now, communication campaign is something what you do step by step. I'll give you an example. For instance, if we have an anti-smoking communication campaign,
mm-hmm.
We want to get people away from smoking.
Okay.
But we have a very specific target.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just telling that within so many years we are going to get so many people away from smoking.
Mm-mm.
But it's within 1 year we are going to get 50% of the youth smokers away from smoking.
Okay.
Let me give you an example. For instance, I was working in a small community radio
mm-hmm.
in Girandrakote in Sri Lanka. So we thought that we could, when we went to hospital, we found out that people who were coming to the hospital, the main reason was a lack of hygiene and sanitation.
Mm-hmm.
So we thought, let they deposit their waste in a hygienic manner.
Okay.
So we thought within 3 weeks,
mm-hmm.
we'll have everyone in the unit have their own waste dump.
Okay.
So now this is a very strategic approach.
Mm-hmm.
And we used our community radio and we used other interpersonal communication to get these people and to encourage them to create their own waste dump.
Okay.
So this is a campaign now.
Okay, so that is a campaign.
Right.
So why is it that we need to go for a communication campaign?
Yes, now certain problems cannot be achieved through a wider communication program. You need to be very strategic, you need to be very focused.
Okay.
It's like getting ready for an exam.
Exactly.
When you are getting ready for an exam, you need to be strategic, you need to be focused. You know, when you are going to make your short notes, when you are going to make your write answers to your past papers, when are you going to memorize, and on the last day of the exam, what are you going to do? You are very strategic. It's like that. Certain things can be achieved
mm-hmm.
only through strategically using a communication. That's where you need the campaign.
Okay. So can you tell us what are the important components of a communication campaign?
Right. Now, as I said, it's going to be strategic and it's going to be focused.
Yes.
So then if you are doing something strategic,
okay.
you have to plan it step by step.
Mm-hmm.
I think first you start by situation analysis.
Situation analysis.
Right.
Okay.
Now, situation analysis, if you remember, Wilbur Schramm,
mm-hmm.
he says communication can do some things, communication can't do some things.
Mm-hmm.
And in the in-between, you find an area where communication can help to do some things.
Okay.
So when you select a topic, you have to analyze and find out the situation whether communication could be used to resolve this problem.
Okay.
Now, there are some problems. How much ever you communicate, you cannot resolve the problem.
Mm-mm.
For instance, let's take the huge traffic blocks that we are having.
Okay.
It's not just a communication problem.
Yes.
You need better roads, you need better public transport.
Mm-mm.
So without better public transport and good roads, just having only communication doesn't help. But there are other things which you have achieved. For instance, in the family planning area, there's been huge success by using communication.
Yes.
Use of fertilizer.
Exactly.
Because the service delivery was available.
Mm-hmm.
If the fertilizer is available and if the missing link is communication, that is the area where we use communication. So we start off with a situation analysis, right?
Mm-hmm.
So first you go to the community, or you think what's your target audience, and you analyze the situation.
Mm-mm.
Then next what you do is you have to set your objectives.
Objectives.
Now your objective should be very specific.
Mm-hmm.
It should be, you should know who is your target audience.
Mm-hmm.
You should know what you are going to achieve out of this,
okay.
When you are going to achieve out of this, when you are going to achieve this, and how you are going to achieve this.
Mm-mm.
So you should have very specific objectives.
Okay.
Now let's take an example. Say you are having a communication campaign to get children interested in reading.
Reading. Okay.
So then you should have specific objectives. What do you mean by reading?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe reading may mean in a communication campaign within 1 week they should be able to finish at least one book.
Okay.
You're very specific there.
Yes.
But if you just vaguely say that I'm going to get them interested in reading, that's not a communication campaign. So then you have to set your objectives.
Mm-hmm.
Then you go to your target audience.
Okay.
Now when you say children, this is a very vague concept. But if you say children who are getting ready for their O-level exam,
mm-hmm.
or children who are in grade 10,
mm-hmm.
that's a very specific target group.
Okay.
Or children who have just finished the advanced level.
Yes.
So that's a very specific target group. And now here you can find we have a primary target audience,
mm-hmm.
and then there may be secondary target audiences.
Okay.
For instance, if you take smokers,
mm-hmm.
their wives may be the secondary target audience, while you are encouraging, or their children.
Mm-hmm.
On one hand, you are encouraging the smokers to get off smoking, and the support groups may be their children.
Yes.
And you can get the message through their children to them. So there may be the primary target group, and as well as the secondary target audience. Then also you need strategy. Now what strategy are you going to use? For instance, are you going to, if it is smoking, are you going to use the fear appeal?
Mm. The appeals, different appeals.
That's right. Are you going to use the fear appeal? Are you going to frighten them?
Mm-mm.
Show them the lungs of a person who has been smoking heavily.
Yeah, or maybe you can use the humor appeal.
Yes, the humor appeal.
Yes.
How foolish. I don't want to be
sarcastic.
Yeah, I don't want to be sarcastic, or I don't want
to ironic.
Pass judgments on people.
Yes.
But if you say how foolish a smoker is,
yes.
there you are using humor. Or you can use the reward appeal.
Mm-hmm.
If you say if you stop smoking today,
mm-hmm.
you can save this X amount of money.
Yes.
Or if you stop smoking for a week,
yes.
You can buy a CD.
Yeah.
Now that's the reward appeal.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Or you will, or in the first 5 minutes you stop smoking, you will be relieved of these symptoms. That's the reward appeal. So there we develop our strategy and our tactics.
Mm.
What tactics are we going to use here? How are you going to get this, for instance, if you are going to use children?
Yes.
What messages are you going to develop for the children?
Exactly.
What messages are you going to develop for the adults?
Mm-hmm.
So there you have strategy. Then also, now we know we take communication through media, right? We use different media channels. Now, for instance, if you remember the literature of family planning communication campaigns,
mm-hmm.
in that time, the most available media was radio.
Radio, yes.
So they used radio a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But now today there's somewhat a decline in radio,
mm-hmm.
and television has become more popular, and social media.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, tomorrow if you're planning something for the youth,
yes,
definitely you'll have to use, if it's Sri Lanka, you'll have to think about the Facebook.
Yes.
And we know about 97% of Sri Lankans use Facebook, Sri Lankans who use the social media use Facebook, mm-hmm. while only 3% use Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
So there you have to prioritize Facebook over Twitter.
Mm.
And for instance, if it's a rural community, for instance, if you're doing something in a community who cannot read and write,
okay.
maybe radio would be the best medium.
Yes.
And also, we know in media you have to spend money. There's a media spend always. We know television is much more expensive than radio.
Yes.
So then you have to balance the value for money aspect there. And you should see which. And also sometimes it's not only the money, people like certain media, certain mm-hmm. groups like certain media. For instance, if it was housewives who listen to radio while they're at home, maybe phone-ins would be a very good program
option.
Strategy option. No?
Yes.
So like that, it's useful to map out the media choice,
mm-hmm.
which media are you going to use, when and how.
Mm-hmm.
That's very crucial in a media campaign.
Okay. So... can you tell us how do we plan? I mean, planning is important, as
That's
I understand.
Right.
So how do you plan
now,
a communication campaign?
It's like cooking.
Okay.
Once all the ingredients are ready, we have to put them together.
Yes.
There comes our communication plan.
Mm-hmm.
Because if we have just having the ingredients around doesn't help. So put them all together.
Mm-hmm.
So you put them all together. Now, say you have made your decisions now, right?
Yes.
Now you must plan out who is going to do what, when and how.
Mm.
That's the basic of planning.
Okay.
Now we have all the ingredients, we have made our decisions. Now the matter is to put all this together. How do you synchronize it? So here we need a timeline.
Mm-hmm.
A timeline is very crucial.
Okay.
Now you have to develop the timeline. Certain things could be done parallelly.
Okay.
Certain things should be done one after the other.
Okay.
So there you develop your timeline.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, you can develop it at weeks. First week you do this, second week you do this, third week, or first month, second month, and that way, right? And then also parallel to the timeline, you know, you need to find out how you are going to spend your money or your resources.
The budgeting.
The budgeting. So I think the budget and the timeline should be seen side by side.
Mm-hmm.
So it's only then we can have an output. And while you are going through this process,
mm-hmm.
you should think what outcomes are you going to get at each time.
Okay.
So there are two types of evaluation. One type of evaluation is you do your evaluation while you are proceeding,
mm-hmm.
right? So you need to evaluate each step while you are doing this, because then only you can make midterm corrections.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, say, I'm going from here to Kandy.
Okay.
I should know the towns which I'm passing by.
Yes.
Because while I'm going from here to Kandy, mm-hmm. if I'm somewhere at Putlam, that's a problem.
Right.
But if I'm at Kegal, I know, yes, I'm on my route.
Exactly.
Right? It's something like that. So, and then it gives us an opportunity to make midterm corrections.
Right.
And always we need to pre-test our communication material.
Yes.
There are so many stories which tell us,
mm-hmm.
which if you don't pre-test the communication material, it gives you the wrong idea.
Yes.
For instance, in this communication campaign in India, which they used the poor family and the rich family concept.
Mm-hmm.
But in India, those populations, they valued the number of children.
Mm-hmm.
So they thought when the rich family were shown with a limited number of children and a lot of other resources, they said, oh, what is this family? They don't have enough children.
Yeah.
And it was a question for them, because for them the value of children was much higher than the material resources. So that was the wrong communication material there.
Yes.
So
it has to kind of suit
that's
the
right.
context.
Yeah. So then what we do is then we have to implement the program.
Mm-mm.
Now we have identified what we want to do.
Yes.
Now we have all the ingredients together. Now we have put it in. Now it's the cooking process. Now we start implementing it. Right? And so always there's unexpected outcome. That's the most important thing.
Mm-hmm.
Now for instance, again, if I go to one of my experiences,
yeah.
when we told women to in a rural area, we ran a communication campaign to encourage them to boil water.
Okay.
Right? Drinking water. To get clean drinking water,
right.
we asked them to boil it. But they came up with a counter argument. They said, we don't have the firewood.
Mm.
It's easy for you to say, but we are the people who have to find the firewood.
Yes, the ground reality.
The ground realities have to be taken into consideration. And always any communication campaign, you need midterm corrections.
Yes.
And that's the key area, because
mm-hmm.
there is going to be a lot of unexpected results.
Mm-mm. Right.
How do you handle these unexpected scenarios?
Mm-hmm.
So there you need midterm corrections.
Corrections.
And then a communication campaign is different from a program.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't go on forever.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to always think of a final evaluation.
Yes.
Where you see whether you have achieved what you have got.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have not got what you wanted, you must find out why.
Okay.
And always you need to find an exit strategy.
Right.
Because you don't finish a communication campaign and you just don't get off. You must find out how the results will be carried on.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, I remember the BBC World Service Trust Fund,
mm-hmm.
Or the BBC World Service Trust. They had a communication campaign about how to, the importance of washing their hands before having your meals in Cambodia.
Right.
And it was found out that it's very crucial to find out how this practice could be carried forward.
Okay.
Because once the communication campaigns finish,
mm-hmm.
if people stop washing their hands, it's a waste of money.
Yes.
So that's very important.
Right.
Find out an exit strategy.
Yeah. And yes, from your experience, just tell us what are the things that we need to be extra cautious when we plan a communication campaign?
Yeah, I think the first thing is, if we go to the beginning, you should find out, is this a problem which I could really handle using a communication campaign?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the key point.
Okay.
Can I use communication to resolve this problem?
Mm-hmm.
We should be extra cautious about that.
Okay.
Second thing which I see is, can we deliver having this amount of X amount of resources?
Mm-hmm.
Because you need a number, you need certain resources, so you should be realistic.
Okay.
You should be realistic. Can you deliver this within this period of time? It's only then you could have a successful communication campaign.
Right.
And third thing is, I think you should be ready for failure.
Okay.
Because if you cannot take the risk of failure,
mm-hmm.
communication campaigns are not always successful.
Right.
Because there are so many ground realities. Mm-hmm. Because basically what we try to do is to change knowledge, attitude and practices.
Yes.
So if you're doing something for the last 20 years,
mm-hmm.
you would have a reason to do it.
Yeah.
If I just come and tell you to change it, you are not going to change immediately.
Yes.
So you need a lot of